Hey everyone, welcome to my very first virtual review or critique. This is going to be a critique of my students' assignments, which was given to them to create a movie trailer. And the assignment was given with very little specifics to see what they come up with. But already I'm seeing great things. So the first one is titled Scare Conditioning, and it was made with Clip Champ. So we discussed in class what are the different tools we can use. Many of us use our phones where we can do quick edits. Sometimes it's more helpful to go ahead and do it on the desktop because it gives us a better quality, and we'll discuss that more in detail as we progress in the unit, which is cinematography. But for this one, I just want to go ahead and focus on my students' ability to tell the story within a limited amount of time, which is usually what happens in a trailer. You're not able to sell the whole movie, you're not able to tell the whole story, and you have to go ahead and condense it and make it quick and be able to captivate your audience. All right, so let's begin reviewing the movie. So this is for my Prodigy students. I am Mr. Gonzalez. I'm the Prodigy teacher, and I'm proud to review the first assignment. Okay, so I love that we begin with this sort of classic typewriter font. And it's set to the background of basically like dark, in between dark and a little bit, a slither of light. This is after you see a parent or a guardian shutting off the lights, and that's sort of the intro. Okay, let's go ahead and play on. And there's a little bit of static, almost like horror movie type of thing. So in this case, The two characters that we see initially, one of them says something's wrong with Mochi, which I have a little bit of a background information, and I know that it's the cat. So one of the things that I want to tell you is that this is for my student. By the way, I haven't decided whether we're going to be using names because since this is on YouTube, we'll decide later. But for my student, what I would say is spend a little bit more time on establishing the story. I know that I'm very big on telling you guys, hey, make it quick because movie trailers are quick. But go ahead and expand it just a little bit where the two characters in the beginning are trying to establish what the problem might be. So spend a little bit more time, and then we get this great shot of the cat trying to scratch in, which we know kind of ties into the story because he is going to be very essential to solving the mystery, right? So it's almost like a supporting actor in the whole thing. Okay, let's press play. And so it's scratching in. I love the use of the lens and how it's maintaining the focus, right? I love the clarity of the lens, everything about it, just the detail. So we'll talk in more detail about equipment later on, but very often the storytelling is more important. So we might have the best equipment, but unless we know how to tell the story, it's better to use what you have. And so far, you're doing a great job with what you have. It's sharp when it needs to be. Sometimes out of focus in the background with the way it needs to be. That's what we call shallow depth of field, and we achieve that with a very small aperture, right? But as far as the foreground, you can see right here, the cat is sharp, the actor is sharp, it's just beautiful. And the colors are just vibrant. Okay, let's rewind just a little bit. Let's see. So right there, I want to pause it. So this is just so many elements of cinematography that are great about this. The fact that you're using a vantage point to be behind the AC, right? The whole story is centered around some sort of problem that's going on with the air conditioner. But in this case, there isn't shallow depth of field. Everything is in focus, which is deep depth of field. So I like that from the sky to the house, to the yard, all the way to the foreground, to the fan, everything is in focus. So that has to do with you choosing an aperture that is very closed. So we're talking about F22, F32. I also love the converging lines, which the fence creates a converging line. The wall and the back fence create a converging line, leading us to the two main actors in the middle. And we're about to see the story develop. The supporting actor's not having it too much. So you were zooming in and we're getting a clue as to what the problem might be. And I like that you very imaginatively, creatively, went ahead and made that the AC is bleeding blue, if it were to be bleeding. Okay, I still love the static of the letters. I don't exactly understand. I know that there's something going on with the AC, so it's giving you that error message. In this shot, once again, vantage point really close. The cat is in focus. The actor is in focus, or the actress is in focus, but everything in the background is blurry. Love it. Okay, just making everything and the background blurry is that special touch, because that shows your control of the camera and your use of the equipment. I love the different angles. You're coming in, coming out. So we're going to learn a little bit more about coming in. As we know, close up is pretty standard. Everyone knows. And then wide angle shots, and then mid shots, which are in between. Cats run wild. I like, once again, the static of the letters. Then we get a little bit darker as we see our detectives sort of trying to figure out what the problem might be. I love these angles. Even though the lighting is a little bit yellow, and I probably would have recommended that you color balance it, I still like it. It's still very authentic as to what the lighting ought to be. ISO noise, there's a little bit of noise and grain, which is usually something that probably pure technicians would be like, well, we need to fix it a little bit. I like it because it makes it more raw, more authentic, and I like that element of it. Okay, our detective is wearing a mask with a night lamp, trying to get to the bottom of the mystery. Okay, we'll talk a little bit about the placement of the of that letter right there, but besides everything that I've mentioned, you know, it's just such great job on your first go around in storytelling, as far as creating something visual with cinematography, okay, with framing, with telling the story on video. All right, that's it for my first review. Great job, and I look forward to seeing everyone else's assignment. See you soon.